Hello everyone. Today I'm going to explain income from salary, section 15. Let us know the meaning of salary. The term salary for the purpose of Income Tax Act will include both monetary payment as well as non-monetary facilities or perquisites. So salary include monetary payment as well as non-monetary facilities. Monetary payments are those payments which are measured in terms of money. For example, basic salary, bonus, commission and all. Non-monetary facilities are those facilities which are not measured in terms of money. For example, housing facilities, accommodation facilities or medical facilities and all. And these non-monetary facilities are also known as perquisites. Next, in simple, salary include basic, allowances, perquisites, retirement benefits. So we're going to study this in further class. So now I'm going to explain rules governing salary. Under that first one, employer-employee relationship. Let us know the meaning of employer and employee. Employer is a person who provides an employment, or he is the owner of the organization. Employee is a person who is going to render his services in an organization. In return, he'll going to get payment from employer. So there should be a relationship, in the sense employer-employee relationship should be there in order to charge income under head salaries. Only those income which is received by the employees can be charged as income under head salaries. Next one, place of accrual or place of generation. There are three conditions with respect to place of accrual. Under that first one, if any of the salary received in India, then it is deemed to be earned, accrued or arise in India. In second case, if any of the person employed in India and goes abroad on leave, if he receives any salary outside India, then it is deemed to be earned in India. Last case, if any of the employee retires from employment and settles abroad, if after his retirement, if he receives any pension amount outside India, then it is deemed to be earned in India. So these are all three conditions with respect to place of accrual. Next one, no distinction is made between salaries and wages. Let us know the meaning of salary and wages. Salary is a fixed regular amount which is payable on monthly basis. Wages is a hourly payment, but here salary as well as wages are one and the same for this purpose. Next one, salary and professional income distinguish. So there is a difference between salary and professional income. If any of the person earned any income through his profession, then that is called as professional income and it is taxed under section 28. I'll give one simple example. If any of the income earned by the lawyer, it can be treated as his professional income. On the other hand, if he is employed by the company, though he gives legal advices, what all the income earned by that person can be considered as salary. So there is a difference between salary as well as professional income. Next one, receipts from persons other than employer. If any of the persons receive salary other than employer, in that situation it will be taxed under section 56, income from other source. For example, fees, tuition fees, or else any of the valuation remuneration received by college professors. Next one, surrender of salary. If employee want to surrender his salary to central government under section 2 of Voluntary Surrender of Salaries Act, in this situation, salary so surrendered is excluded while computing his taxable income. Next one, salary from more than one employer. If any of the individual is going to receive salary from more than one employer or more than one sources, salary from each source is taxable as salaries. Next one, salary must be real and not fictitious. In the sense, there should be a real payment of salary. There should be an intention to pay salary. There should be an intention to receive salary. So all these points related to rules governing salary. Next, let us know the meaning of basic. Basic is the amount paid to an employee before any extras are added or taken off, such as bonus, overtime, or any kind of extra compensation. So basic is the amount paid to the employee before any amounts, before adding or before deducting some of the amounts. Next, allowances. Let us know the meaning of allowances. The term allowances refers to an amount paid by the employer to his employee in order to enable him to meet certain specific expenses incurred by him for discharging his duties. So allowances is an amount paid by the employer to his employee in order to meet expenses with respect to his or her duties. Next, types of allowances. Following are the fully taxable allowances irrespective of usage or purpose. So all these allowances are fully taxable. If it is used for official purpose or private purpose, all these allowances are fully taxable. Let us discuss one by one. First one, dearness allowance. So dearness allowance are those allowances which are provided to the employees in order to meet high prices. Government employees, public sector employees, pensioner will going to get this dearness allowance, and it is fully taxable for both purpose. If it is used for official purpose or if it is used for private purpose, it is fully taxable. Next one, city compensatory allowance. City compensatory allowance are those allowance which are provided to the employees in big cities in order to meet the expenses of high cost of living. It is also fully taxable for both the purpose. Next one, fixed medical allowance. Fixed medical allowance are those allowance which are provided to the employees in order to meet expenses with respect to medical. It is also fully taxable for both the purpose. Next one, tiffin allowance. Tiffin allowance in the sense it is allowance pertaining to tiffin or in order to meet the expenses of tiffin. It is also fully taxable for both the purpose. So we're going to continue this in the next video. Thank you.